Good morning, MMSD Middle School Scholars. If you are not in class at this time, you are now tardy. T-A-R-D-Y, tardy. We are leaning forward together and taking care of business every day. Excellence matters. This is the year of breakthroughs.
This is how we do it. This is how we do it.
MMSD.
This is Dr. Ebby reminding us that MMSD vision is to work collaboratively to ensure all scholars have access to high quality, equitable, inclusive instruction and services, leading to deep learning and resulting in college, career, and community readiness.
Announcements for today. Today is a compassionate day. Let's stay engaged, build meaningful and authentic relationships with one another, and learn all that we can, and have a memorable Monday. We are middle school scholars, focused on a high achievement and excellence. I want you to affirm yourself by saying after me, I can learn anything.
I can learn anything.
I can know anything.
I can know anything.
I can be anything.
I can be anything.
Have a great day or not. The choice is yours.
Our moment in Black history. Madam C.J. Walker invented a line of African-American hair products after suffering from a scalp ailment that resulted in her own hair loss. She promoted her products by traveling around the country, giving lecture demonstrations, and eventually established Madam C.J. Walker Laboratories to manufacture cosmetics and train sales beauticians. Walker was born Sarah Breedlove on December 23rd, 1867, on a cotton plantation near Delta, Louisiana. Her parents, Owen and Minerva, were recently freed slaves, and Sarah, who was their fifth child, was the first in her family to be freeborn. Sarah found work as a washerwoman, earning $1.50 a day, enough to send her daughter to the city's public schools. While in St. Louis, Breedlove met her second husband, Charles J. Walker, who worked in advertising and would later help promote her hair care business. Her business acumen led her to be one of the first American women to become a self-made millionaire. She was also known for her philanthropic endeavors, including a donation toward the construction of an Indianapolis YMCA in 1913. Walker died of hypertension on May 25th, 1919, at age 51, at Villa Lavaro. In 1927, the Walker Building, an art center that Walker had begun work on before her death, was opened in Indianapolis. An important African-American cultural center for decades is now a registered National Historic Landmark.
Black history is all of our history. It is American history. I want to give a shout out to all of our middle school principals for leading and supporting all scholars, staff, families, and our school communities. Way to go, principals! Have a great day.